We will discuss the about the anterior triangle of the neck. Our objectives to discuss about the boundaries of the triangles, content of the triangles, and clinical aspect of the triangle. First of all, we will discuss the muscular triangle. Muscular triangle posteriorly and inferiorly, this is the sternocleidomastoid muscles. Posteriorly and inferiorly, it is bounded by the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid. Anteriorly, it is bounded by the anterior midlines. This one is the anterior midlines. And superiorly and posteriorly, it is bounded by the superior belly of homoid. Postero-superiorly, it is bounded by the superior belly of homoid. Postero-inferiorly, it is bounded by the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid, and anteriorly by the anterior midlines. The content of the muscular triangle, this is the muscular triangles. Content, sternohyoid. This one is the superior belly of homoid. Superior belly of homoid. This one is the superior belly of homoid. This one is the sternohyoid. Once we reflect the sternohyoid, we will see the two another muscles. From sternum to thyroid, it is called the sternothyroid. And thyroid to hyoid, it is called the thyrohyoid.
This is the oblique line.
This one is the oblique line which gives the insertion of the sternothyroid and thyrohyoid origins. All the muscles are, it is called the infrahyoid muscles, which is supplied by the ansa cervicalis.
Now we will
discuss about the ansa cervicalis.
For that purpose,
we reflect the sternocleidomastoids. You can see this one is the common carotid artery.
This one is also
superior belly of and inferior belly of homoid. We reflect the
homohyoid. And here you can see this loop.
This one is the
loop. You can see
C1
this
C1 fibers, which is along with the
hypoglossal.
Hypoglossal nerves. This one is the hypoglossal nerve. This one is the hypoglossal nerve. The fiber of the C1 goes along with the hypoglossus, and these are the fibers of the C1 which is continuous, which directly supplies to the genioid and thyroid muscles. But the C1, the nerve C1 itself, it supplies the superior belly of homoid. You can see these fibers of the C1 supplies the superior belly of. This one is the ansa cervicalis itself. It gives supplies to the thyrohyoid. It supplies to the sternothyroid and also it supplies to the inferior belly of the homoid. This one is the nerves to the inferior belly of the homoid. This one is the fiber of the ansa cervicalis coming from the C2 and C3, and it is united with the fiber of the C1, and it makes complete the ansa cervicalis over the common carotid vessels.